peer ministers today are going to be kind of launching a project that we've been working on for the last couple of weeks called the Clothespins Project. This idea of writing down scripture passages on a clothespin, and then on the back of the clothespin, writing maybe like a short part of that verse, so like a keyword or phrase that would kind of entice you all to take a look at what that passage is all about, because most of you probably will not know what that Phil 4:13 passage is. And so it would lead you to open up a Bible, look it up online, and find out what is that particular message of encouragement. So when you receive a clothespin, it's going to be something that's probably like placed on you anonymously, and you won't even know that it's happening, most likely. Look at that passage, look it up, and allow it to be something that can speak to you in the midst of your life and be that encouragement, be that support, but help you to really grow also in putting your faith over your fears. When we look at the theme for this year in campus ministry, it's all about being fearless, right? Putting your faith over fear. And, first semester, we talked a lot about what those fears were. We identified that. And in the second semester, we really are wanting to look at how we can put our faith over our fear. And one of the biggest ways we can do that is not only through a community that supports each other and encourages, each other in the midst of different challenges that we face, but also looking to how God can be what helps us through different hard times and even good times as well. So that's really the Clothespins Project.
So the purpose of the Clothespin activity is to spread positivity and encouragement to all of our peers, as well as spread Jesus' good news through the Bible verse that we put on the back of each clothespin.
So once you get a clothespin, we encourage you to look up the Bible verse and then to pass it on, not to your friends, but to someone that you think needs it.
This is so bad. After all this time, I can't believe it.
Deacon, it's okay.
What do I need to do?
It's okay, Deacon. Have a good day.
Filled with joy. Romans chapter 15, verse 30. God is good.
I got a 64 on the calculus test, and I have 2 supplements today. I'm literally not going to be able to do it. So, yeah. Come on, let's go to the bathroom.
I can do all things through Him who strengthens me.
So I think that this project is really important because I even had a personal experience with it, and I think it's going to be really wonderful if everyone gets into the spirit of it. Sometimes we feel like God isn't there, that no one can relate or nobody understands. But really, I think this activity has like the potential to help us to see that we just sometimes have to look a little bit harder, and that God wants to be with us and wants to share in what is going on in our life. And sometimes we just have to look for it. We need to be open to hearing what He has to say to us. So be open, and I hope that you hear some really great news on your clothespin.